Good morning, students. I'm Prem Gupta, your English teacher. Dear students, in the previous classes, we were discussing the chapter first, Who Did Patrick's Homework? Who did Patrick's homework? And in which we have discussed the summary and explanation of that chapter. And we have also completed the question answer of that chapter and word meaning also. And there is a poem that is prescribed for reading. That is A House, A Home, that is composed by the Lauren and Holly. Okay? Says a poetess, and she has written a very good poem, that is A House, A Home. And dear students, it is given in your book at the page number 15. Just open the book, and it is also, I have also written it on the board, and you can also see it. Just see the poem. What is house? In this poem, the poet is just describing about the house and home. Here, this poet is just differentiate what is house and what is home. Okay, student, just see the poem, read the poem, recite the poem. What is house? There are two stanza in this poem. And in the first stanza, the poetess is talking about house. In the second stanza, the poetess is talking about home. So here we can see in the first stanza first, what is house? Here in the first line, the poetess is asking the question that what is a house? Okay, what is a house? And in the rest of the lines of the first stanza, the poetess is giving the answer that what is a house. Just see here. What is a house? This is the question in the first line, but from the next line we will get the answer. It's brick and stone. It's brick and stone and woods that hard. Some windows, glass, perhaps a yard. It's eaves and chimney and tile floors and stucco and roof and lots of door. Dear students, in these stanza, the poetess is talking about the quality of a house and what do we find in a house and what is a house. The answer of this question is here. The in the first stanza, the poetess is talking about house and she was saying that a house is a non-living thing. A house is a non-living thing. Just see here, it is made up of bricks. And it is made up of bricks and stones. And a house is made up of bricks and stone, and there is woods, that house. And in the house, we also find woods, furnitures. And there are so many non-living things in the house. So, here the poet is saying that a house is made up of bricks, stones and woods, that is hard, that is non-living thing. And in the house we also find some windows glass, and in the house we also find some windows glass. In the house there are so many windows. Okay, in the house there are so many rooms, and in each room there are so many windows, so many doors. Okay, just see, some windows glass, perhaps a yard. Yard means courtyard. In a house we also find a courtyard. Courtyard is a place in the house. Just see, some windows glass and perhaps a yard. In the house we also find a yard. Yard means courtyard. And the next, it's eaves. Eaves means it is a kind of part of roof. It is a part of roof that meets the wall. It is a part of roof that meets the wall. जिसको हम लोग गांव में ओरी भी बोलते हैं. ठीक है, जैसे दिस इज द हाउस, सपोज दैट दिस इज द हाउस, सो दिस पॉइंट दैट बेंड्स, दैट बेंडिंग पॉइंट इज नोन एज ईव्स. अंडरस्टूड स्टूडेंट्स? इट्स ईव्स एंड चिमनी, एंड देयर इज ऑल्सो अ चिमनी इन द हाउस फ्रॉम वेयर द स्मोक्स केम आउट, एंड इट्स टाइल्स फ्लोर. इन द हाउस वी ऑल्सो फाइंड द टाइल फ्लोर्स, एंड द फ्लोर्स ऑफ द हाउस इज मेड अप ऑफ टाइल्स. ओके, एंड स्टुको, स्टुको, स्टुको मीन्स प्लास्टर, इट इज अ काइंड ऑफ प्लास्टर, फाइन प्लास्टर. एंड स्टुको एंड रूफ, एंड द रूफ वॉज ऑल्सो मेड अप ऑफ प्लास्टर. एंड लॉट्स ऑफ डोर, एंड इन द हाउस वी ऑल्सो फाइंड लॉट्स ऑफ डोर. इन द हाउस वी फाइंड सो मेनी रूम्स, एंड इन ईच रूम वी ऑल्सो फाइंड द डोर्स. सो दिस दीज आर द क्वालिटी ऑफ अ हाउस द पोएट इज डिस्क्राइबिंग हियर. वॉट इज हाउस? सो हाउस इज अ नॉन लिविंग थिंग. हियर हियर द पोएट इज डिस्क्राइबिंग द हाउस एज ए नॉन लिविंग थिंग, एंड इट इज मेड अप ऑफ ब्रिक्स, स्टोन्स, वुड्स, विंडोज, एंड देयर इज ऑल्सो अ यार्ड, ईव्स, चिमनी, एंड टाइल्स फ्लोर, स्टुको एंड रूफ, एंड देयर आर लॉट्स ऑफ डोर्स. ओके स्टूडेंट, दीज आर द क्वालिटीज दैट हैज बीन डिफाइंड बाय द राइटर द पोएट इन दिस स्टैंजा. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, एंड नाउ सी द सेकेंड स्टैंजा ऑफ द पोयम. जस्ट सी व्हाट इज अ होम, जस्ट सी व्हाट इज अ होम. हियर इन द फर्स्ट लाइन अगेन द पोएट इज आस्किंग द क्वेश्चन दैट व्हाट इज अ होम. इन दिस पैर इन दिस स्टैंजा द पोएट इज आस्किंग द क्वेश्चन दैट व्हाट इज अ हाउस. एंड इन द सेकेंड स्टैंजा द पोएट इज आस्किंग दैट व्हाट इज अ होम. सो द इन द रेस्ट ऑफ द लाइन्स द आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन व्हाट इज अ होम इट इज गिवेन इन द नेक्स्ट लाइन. इट्स लविंग एंड फैमिली. हियर द पोएट इज टॉकिंग दैट अ हाउस इज नॉन लिविंग थिंग बट अ होम इज अ लिविंग थिंग. A home is a living things and it is made up of loving and family, and it is made up of with loving people, that is a family. In the family there are so many peoples, and a home is made up of peoples. Okay, you see, it's loving and family, it's loving and family and doing for others, and the each members of the family were doing the helps for each others. Okay, what is a home? It's loving and family, it is a kind of family. A home is a family and doing for others, and everyone do the works for other, it means everyone is helping to each other. And doing for others, it's brother, and in a home we find brothers and sisters and fathers and mothers, and a home is consist of brothers, sister, fathers and mothers. Okay, that is the family, and it's unselfish act and kindly sharing. And here there is no selfness, there is unselfish act is performed by the each members of the family, that is it's unselfish act and kindly sharing, and everyone shares the problems, shares the happiness, shares the work with each other in the home. In the home we find brothers and sisters, fathers and mothers, and grandfathers, grandmothers, so many members. Okay, just see, and Everyone is act without any kind of selfness. Everyone has love for each other, and everyone shares kindly sharings, and everyone shares the feelings to each other, everyone shares the works to each other, everyone shares the problems and joyfulness also with each other. That is the quality of a home, and it is a kind sharing and kindly sharing and showing your loved ones. You are always caring, and everyone showing the love for each other, and you are always caring in the family, and everyone will care you in the family. Dear students, I hope that you all have understand the difference between the house and a home. Here the poet is describing or narrating that what is a house and what is a home. In this poem, the poetess is talking about house in the first stanza, and she is saying that a house is made of bricks, stones, wood, and there are so many window glass, and there may be a yard, courtyard, and there is also the eaves and chimney and tiles floor in the house, and that is stucco and roof. And a house is also in the house we also find the stucco and roof and lots of door. In the house we also find lots of door. There are so many rooms, and each room there may be a doors. And in the second stanza, the poetess is talking about what is home. And here the poetess is saying that it is a kind of loving materials, we cannot say materials, loving people are there, and it's loving family. It is a kind of family members. It is made up of family members, and everyone do the works for each other, and there are so many people, brothers, sisters, fathers, mother, and there is also the unselfish act. We find the unselfish act in the family member, and everyone shares their feelings with each other and with the family members, and they were also showing the loved ones, and everyone also cared and loved with the members of the family, and you are always caring in a house, in a home. So this is all about the poem. Dear students, I hope that you all have understand the difference between the house and a home. So therefore the title of this poem is A House, A Home. Okay students, now just turn the page. There is some exercises that you have to complete in your book, not in the copy. You have to complete in your book. Just open the book and put out the pencil without getting late. Just do. I am going to erase it. Just open the book and put out the pencil. Okay student, just see page number 16, just open. Here the question is written here in the book. Do you agree with what the poet says? Talk to your partners and complete the answer. Here some filling the blanks are given, and that you have to complete. Okay, in the first question, just see. A house is made up of, here the question is written, that is not question, that is filling the blanks. You can say, you have to complete the sentence. Here it is written, in your book it is written, and we have to fill in the book only, no need to write in the notebook. A house is made up to this it is given in your book, and after that you have to write, and here you have to fill. What will you fill? A house is made up of, just write down the answer, hard bricks, brick, comma stones, and wood. Hard bricks, stones, and wood. Okay, this is the answer. Stones and wood. And the second, Gussie. It has, here, second, it has, here it is written, it has, after that you have to fill, it has, what are, it has, window, just fill, it has window, house is has window, window glass, a yard, chimney, comma tile floors, doors and roof, okay, this is the second answer. And the third, let's see. A home is made by, and up to this it is written, and the next you have to fill, loving and caring parents, brothers and sisters, just fill in your book that is given at the page number 16. And the question number 4. Just see the question number 4. It has means a home has. It is given. What it has? Family members. Who cares for each? For each other. without any selfish motives. Without any selfish motives. Okay, students. And the next question, second question. Now complete these sentences about your house and home. Second question. Just fill in the book. Just sit down. The question is given here. My house is, up to this it is written. My house is, up to this it is written, and you have to fill. My house is also made up of, just write down, made up of bricks, bricks, comma, marbles, and tiles. And tiles. It has beautiful window. It has beautiful windows. Made up of glass with a balcony and a roof. And the next, and that is the last. Okay, student, second question is given here. It is not working. The best thing about my home is, the best thing about my home is, up to this it is given, and we have to fill now. Home is that, just fill in the book. All of us understand, all of have understand and help each other, and help each other in any distress. We live together peacefully Okay, up to this you have to write. Dear student, this is all about the chapters. In this way, the chapter first completed, in which in the beginning there is a story, but in the last portion of the first chapter there is a poem, a house, a home. And we have read this poem with explanation, and we have also completed the exercises that is given, that is based on the poem A House and Home. And dear students, one more thing there, that is one more question generally comes in the examination, that is extract based question. Okay student, that question I will send you in the WhatsApp group, and in which some stanza of the poems will be given to you, and some question will be asked on the basis of that stanza. So after reading the stanza, you have to give the answer. I will send that question in your WhatsApp group. And dear students, in this way this poem has been completed. If you have any kind of problem, you can share with me. Okay, so thanks for today.